गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर विनीत सहगल एंड वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू दिस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सेशन इन द न्यूमरो यूनो इन ऑफ्थल्मोलॉजी सीरीज. टुडे वी वुड बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट इज नॉट ओनली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द पीजी एंट्रेंस एग्जाम, इट इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द थर्ड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स एंड माई इंटर्न्स एंड द ऑप्टोमेट्रिस्ट. द टॉपिक दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे इज वेरी क्लोज टू माई हार्ट, दैट इज द लेंस इंड्यूस्ड ग्लूकोमा. So before I start the session, an introduction of the module, that is the Unacademy Let's Crack NEET PG preparation module. You can have a lots of classes if you download this Unacademy learning app from the Play Store. It is there available on the iOS as well as Android platform, and you can get a 10% discount on getting my code, on putting my code, that is Ophthel10. You can basically have a lots of educators who are going to teach you the basics and the concepts about the various chapters, about the various subjects. We have different schedules which are the INICT as well as the FMG batch going on, and you can also subscribe for the Unacademy as well as PrepLadder platform, where you would get the additional advantage of the Unacademy platform as well as the preparation module and the rapid revision notes and the video lectures of the PrepLadder app by using my code DrVinit10. So I'm going straight to the topic that I'm going to discuss today, that is lens induced glaucoma. So crystalline lens, if it basically increases in its size and it basically advances, it can also lead to glaucoma. Okay, so what it does is that because of some causative agents that I would be discussing today, that would cause the increase in intraocular pressure, and this intraocular pressure, if increased for a longer time, it can cause glaucoma. So what are the various types of the lens induced glaucoma? So as we divide the glaucoma, primary glaucoma, into two types, the open angle and the angle closure, similarly we divide the lens induced glaucoma also into two types. So we have the lens induced open angle glaucoma and the lens induced angle closure glaucoma. Okay, so both of them are secondary to the lens, so these are all secondary glaucomas. Okay, sometimes they ask what are the types of secondary glaucoma. So you should remember that the lens induced glaucoma, it is one of the most common type of the secondary glaucoma. Which is the most common one? That can also be the question. So if they ask the most common secondary glaucoma, okay, then your answer is pseudo exfoliation glaucoma. We would discuss about the pseudo exfoliation in a separate topic, but if they ask the most common secondary glaucoma, then it is the pseudo exfoliation glaucoma, and it is particularly more seen in the Kashmiri population. When I go to Srinagar, in my center we have a eye hospital in the Srinagar also, I see a lot of cases who are basically suffering from the pseudo exfoliation glaucoma. Now what are the various types of lens open angle glaucomas, or we would say what are the secondary open angle glaucomas that can be caused by the lens? So they are basically, first of all you should remember, phacoelytic glaucoma. The second is the lens particle glaucoma, and the third one is phacoanaphylactic glaucoma. Okay, these are the types of open angle glaucomas. Okay, and the angle closures, we have phacomorphic glaucoma and the other type of angle closure glaucoma. Because of the lens, it can be microspherophakia. Okay, now we would study all of them one by one. So first of all, what is the phacoelytic glaucoma? sometimes what happens is whenever there is a hypermature senile cataract. Can you see this hypermature senile cataract? Everyone just give me a thumbs up. So hypermature senile cataract, let's say if it is the Morgagnon variety or the sclerotic variety, because of the so much mature cataracts or hypermature cataract, because of this, there occurs micropores in the capsule of the lens. Okay, from these micropores, what happens is the lens antigens can go in the anterior chamber. So this is my anterior chamber. Okay, so these lens antigens can come into this anterior chamber, and slowly and slowly when this lens antigens come into the anterior chamber, then there would be inflammation, macrophages here, and these macrophages and the inflammatory material block the trabecular meshwork. Are you getting my point? Okay, so they block the trabecular meshwork, which causes increased resistance to the aqueous outflow, which causes the increased IOP. So what would be the clinical scenario here? The clinical scenario here would be that, let's say a 65 year old male came to the OPD. He says that, sir, I was having a low vision maybe for 6 months or maybe for a year, and now I am having increased pain and redness of the eye. When you see the anterior chamber, very important thing that you would see, there is a deep anterior chamber. Now this is the differentiating factor between the open angle and the closed angle glaucoma. So open angle glaucoma, there would be always a deep anterior chamber, and when you see the anterior segment, there would be cells and flare there, and the pressures would be very high, maybe 60 millimeter of mercury, and you see a hypermature senile cataract in these cases. Okay, so these can be the potential clinical scenario which we get in a patient who is suffering from phacolytic glaucoma. Any doubts till now? Okay, let's see. So I think some issues with the network. Okay, so now the second type of the glaucoma is lens particle glaucoma. Now what is actually a lens particle glaucoma? In lens particle glaucoma, the things are a bit different. Okay, so what the IOP is increased is because of the obstruction of the aqueous outflow by the lens particles. Okay, I would just give me a minute, I would just put a slide here. Okay, so the next type of glaucoma, I call it lens particle glaucoma. Now this lens particle glaucoma, this is also a type of, is my slide visible to all of you? Is my slide visible to all of you? Okay, so the lens particle glaucoma, it is also a type of secondary open angle glaucoma. Okay, now what happens here is that this intraocular pressure elevation, it is caused by the obstruction out of outflow by the lens particles. Okay, so what is happening is that, let's say there is a injury to the anterior capsule. Remember, in the phacolytic glaucoma, a very important point is the lens capsule is intact. Okay, you have no deficiency or no break in the continuity of the lens capsule. Okay, so the lens capsule is intact in phacolytic glaucoma. Okay, but what happens in the lens particle glaucoma, there is a breach in the integrity of the anterior capsule of the crystalline lens. Okay, now what it causes? Now remember, your crystalline lens, here it is basically two capsules. Okay, they are basically enclosing the nuclear and the cortical material. Now if I go to the embryology of the lens, these lens particles, these are basically sequestered antigens. Have you ever heard the name sequestered antigens? So what happens is, whenever there is a break in the continuity, these lens particles, they can basically come in the anterior chamber, and then these lens particles, they basically cause the obstruction of the trabecular meshwork. Okay, and they can find then cause the increase in the intraocular pressure. Okay, so a very fine difference here is that in the phacolytic and the lens particle glaucoma, the presentation can be very similar, but there would be history of the breach of anterior capsule of the lens in your lens particle glaucoma. So what can be the conditions which can cause lens particle glaucoma? So they would give a different clinical scenario. So the clinical scenario would be, let's say the patient has got a corneal perforation or trauma to the eye, and after this perforating trauma, you have basically repaired the cornea, but still on the follow-up, you have seen that there is a fluffy lens material in the anterior chamber because of the damage to the anterior capsule, and this has caused increase in the IOP. Okay, so what is the very essential important factor in the lens particle glaucoma? That there is a breach in the anterior capsule of the lens, and this has caused the lens particles or the lens material to come into the anterior chamber. You should be able to see the lens material into the anterior chamber, and this has caused the increased intraocular pressure. Okay, so this is basically the funda of the lens particle glaucoma. So how it can happen? It can happen post trauma or even after any intraocular surgery. Okay, let's say you have done a ECC or a SICS. Okay, and after ECC, that is the extracapsular cataract extraction, or SICS, you still have some material, some lenticular material which is left, and this has come into the anterior chamber, and that has caused your lens particle glaucoma. Okay, then the third type of the secondary lens induced open angle glaucoma, that is called phacoanaphylactic glaucoma, or this is also called phacotoxic glaucoma. Now this is the rarest form of glaucoma. Okay, so this is the rarest form of lens induced glaucoma. Now what it actually means? It actually means that these lens particles, which are the sequestered antigens, now they somehow are coming into the anterior chamber. Okay, like your phacolytic glaucoma, same thing is that these lens antigens has come into the anterior chamber, and now they have basically started a very fast immune response. Okay, so it is something, a allergic mechanism, or maybe you can say it is a arthrosis type of immune response. Okay, very fast immune response to the lens particles. Okay, so this basically comes into the anterior chamber, and it suddenly causes increase in the intraocular pressure. It suddenly causes very severe increase in the intraocular pressure, and this causes the phacoanaphylactic glaucoma, we also call it phacoantigenic glaucoma or we also call it phacotoxic glaucoma. Now this can happen from the hypermature senile cataract, and it can sometime happen after a few days of cataract surgery also. So this means that now the anterior chamber is sensitized to these particles, and these sensitization of the particles now after some time has got a rapid increase in the IOP. This is called a anaphylactic type of glaucoma, or this is called a phacoanaphylactic glaucoma. Okay, so now we conclude this. The open angles, we have the phacolytic, which is because of the macrophages and the lens particles in the anterior chamber. We have the lens induced glaucoma, okay, lens particle glaucoma, which is because of the lens particles or the lens material into the anterior chamber after there is a break in the continuity of the anterior capsule. And then we have the phacoanaphylactic, which is basically a anaphylactic or a arthrose type of immune response to already sensitized lens particles in the anterior chamber. Okay, now the next type of glaucoma is the phacomorphic glaucoma. Before I go to the phacomorphic glaucoma, a few points regarding the toxic cataract. Sometimes students confuse the phacotoxic glaucoma, okay, that is your phacoanaphylactic glaucoma, with the toxic cataract. Remember, toxic cataract does not mean it is glaucoma. Okay, it does not mean it is glaucoma. It just means that there is a drug induced cataract, like corticosteroid induced cataract. Okay, so it may be having a coexisting increased intraocular pressure, or it may not be having, but toxic cataract does not mean glaucoma. Okay, a very important point that you have to remember. Okay, then the second type of cataract, which is more easy to understand, that is the phacomorphic glaucoma. Now what happens in a phacomorphic glaucoma is, let's say this is your cornea, and because of the intumescent lens, okay, intumescent means, let's say there is a swollen lens, what it causes is, it causes iris to come more forward. Okay, it causes the iris to come forward, and this causes the angle closure. Okay, can you see? Now this angle is reduced. And why it is reduced? Because of the swollen crystalline lens. Okay, so a intumescent lens, it may be mature cataract, it may be a hypermature cataract, but it should be increased anteroposterior diameter. If the cataract is like this, this would basically push the iris forward, and this would cause the blockage of the angles, which would cause the angle closure glaucoma. Okay, this would cause the angle closure glaucoma. Okay, this is called phacomorphic glaucoma. It is more seen in the intumescent cataract. Sometimes they ask hypermature. So if it is a viva question, it's not hypermature, it is the intumescent, or you can say swollen cataract, you see more of the phacomorphic glaucoma. Now the next question is, sometimes they ask about the microspherophakia, which type of glaucoma is seen there. So normally the cataract is like this, okay, it is biconvex in structure, but sometimes it is more round in its configuration, more oval in its configuration. So when it becomes more oval, this happens sometimes when there is a small eyeball. Okay, so you have a small eyeball, and when the lens becomes swollen, it can also cause the iris to come forward. Okay, so there are two things which are basically contributing. The first thing is the oval nature of the lens, and second thing is small eyeball. Okay, both the things are contributing, And this, as you can see, what it is causing is, it is causing the obliteration of the angle. So this also causes a secondary angle closure glaucoma. Okay, so the microspherophakia and sometimes even the anteriorly displaced ectopia lentis, okay, the subluxation of lens, they also by the same mechanism can cause a angle closure glaucoma. Now what is the treatment of these different type of lens induced glaucoma? So as the culprit is the lens, you have to remove the lens. So the definitive treatment of the lens induced glaucoma is the removal of the lens. Okay, and this removal of the lens we have to do after stabilization of the IOP. Okay, so you have to try to decrease the intraocular pressure, and when the intraocular pressure is basically decreased, then you can go for the cataract surgery. So some students ask me, do you need to do TRAB in all the cases? Do you need to do TRAB in all the cases of lens induced glaucoma? The answer is no. What is the basic parameter? The basic parameter is, let's say the patient is having a phacolytic or phacoanaphylactic or a lens particle glaucoma. So there is a uveitis there, or the macrophages which are basically, or the inflammation which is basically causing the increased IOP. So what you do is, you give the steroids, topical steroids, which would decrease the inflammation, and after decreasing the inflammation, what you do is, you start the patient on carbonic anhydrase inhibitors, beta blockers you can give, you can give systemic IV mannitol, and you can also give alpha agonist. So all these basically are causing decrease in the IOP. When both of them have caused the decrease in the IOP as well as decrease in the inflammation, you can go ahead with the small incision cataract surgery, ECC, and if you are a great surgeon, you can go with the phacoemulsification also. Okay, and in the phacomorphic glaucoma, you start the patient. So if let's say there is a angle closure phacomorphic glaucoma, you basically decrease the IOP with the IV mannitol, and then you are doing a cataractous extraction. Now then you would ask me, sir, when to do TRAB here? When should we go with the trabeculectomy? So if the IOP is not controlled even after the medical management, then you go with the trabeculectomy and you go with the cataract extraction, and this you can do simultaneously. Okay, so this sometimes they basically refer as a triple procedure. Okay, sometimes they ask in the exam, what is the triple procedure? So triple procedure is trabeculectomy plus phaco plus intraocular lens implantation. Sometimes you need to do this procedure also in your patients. Okay, so this is all about what you should know about the lens induced glaucoma. So if you have liked the lecture, please click on the like button and subscribe for this channel. If you want to basically join our Unacademy program, you can go with the plus course and the iconic subscription and use my code OFTHAL10 to get a 10% discount on whatever course that you want. Thank you very much for watching this class, and tomorrow also I would be there at 10:30 p.m. with another important class. So hit the bell icon for getting the notifications.